Hello friends, in this video there are two things that I'm going to cover. Firstly, how to get the project running on a Windows machine, because that's a request that I've got. And secondly, I'm going to show you how you can rectify this particular H2 database error that you get once you get the H2 database jar file and then you open it and you try to connect to that particular database. So it gives you this particular error where it is not able to found the database or it does not allow remote database creation. You're not going to go for the remote database creation because that will leave a security hole, but we are going to create it based on the user credential that we have used to log into this particular machine. So I'm going to cover up both of this thing. So let's begin. First, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how you can clone the project on this particular Windows machine. So what I'm using here is Spring STS. So what you can do, you can go to this website that is Spring IO Tools, and you can get the STS downloaded for yourself based on your operating system. In my previous video, I have shown you how you can do it on Mac. Now you can do it for Windows. You can download it for Windows and then get your Spring STS running, or you can use any Eclipse IDE that supports your Java Enterprise Edition development. So that's all you need to do. And also you will require Tomcat. So you can use Tomcat 8.5 or any higher version to work with this particular project. So that I've already downloaded and installed. So I'll be quick with this particular demo. So you can go to Windows menu, go to Show View, and then go to Other, search for Git, and then you need to select Git repositories. Click on Open. Now here you'll get this particular button called as Clone at Git Repository, or you can use this second button, which also gives the same option of cloning that particular Git repository. So you can just click on this Clone a Git Repository. Now you need to go to my repository URL that I've already shared earlier also. You can make a note of this. It is github.com/josema-nalwala/online-shopping. Then you can just copy this particular URL and we'll come back here and just paste it here. And this is the host and this is the repository path. We don't have to give the username and password because that is not required. It's a public repository, so we can just remove this. And then you can click on next. Now it will give you some branches that is related to some security. That's fine, but I'm not going to select this one. We need to only select the master one. And then we're going to click on next. It will ask you which directory you need to save this. So I have a directory with the name of project. So I will be using the same project directory and saving it inside this as online shopping. So I'll just click on save. You can see the directory destination is C project online shopping. And then I'm going to click on finish. So what is happening, it is trying to clone my project and bring it in my local machine. So that project is available here, as you can see, but it is not imported in my package explorer. So what I need to do is I need to right click here on this online shopping and then say import projects. Now once you click on this import project, it will detect what kind of a project it is. So it says import as Maven project because it has that pom.xml file. So I just remove this top level directory, but I'm going to use this online shopping and shopping backend because both are my Maven project. And then I'll click on finish. Now it will start updating that particular Maven project and it will try to download those dependencies if those dependencies are not available. So you need to be a little patient based on your network bandwidth and the internet connectivity. It will try to download all those dependencies. And in case if you face any challenge, you can refer my part 003rd video. And then you can see how you can rectify that particular error, because what happens sometimes is the dependencies are not downloaded properly and there is some kind of an error, the null pointer exception and invalid LOC header, zip exception, those kind of error you get. If you get those kind of an error, what you need to do is you need to open the run and you can access the user directory directly by pressing dot. So if I press dot here and then press enter, it will take you to the user directory, and inside this user directory you can see this .m2 directory is there. So all your dependencies are cached in this particular directory. So I'll go to repository and you can see those repositories are available here. Now my project uses Spring framework. So the Spring framework is available inside org. And then we'll go and check the Spring framework. And then you have all the others. So let me open up and show you the web MVC one, because that is what I've been using. So you can see the different version, how it maintains. And you can refer the project and you can just delete that particular dependency. Now, not necessary, it would be for your Spring Web MVC. It could be for any dependency that you have downloaded. So let's say if I open this 4.3.6, you can see those jar files are available here. So if it does not get downloaded properly, that's the only time you're going to find there is an error in this particular project, because I cloned this particular project here itself and you can see there are no errors right now. Fine. Now you also need to add a server to this one, that is our Tomcat server. So you can go to show view once again in window show view and you can click on this servers. So it will open up this particular server window. It says no servers are available. So I'm going to add that particular server. So from this window, I'm going to search for Apache Tomcat and then I will select the version 8.5 because I have 8.5 available in my machine. So I'll click on next. And you can see it's ready to add this particular online shopping. Let's say if it was not available, all you need to do is to configure it. You can add from where you can find it. So you can see my installation is available on Cedar. It may ask you for this where your Apache Tomcat installation is available. So it is available in my C drive. So I want to use that one. Okay, I can just change the name of this and this is not required. I can just say it's already used. Okay, fine. So I can just make it as Tomcat 8.5. That is also fine. I'm just changing the configuration for this one. It's Tomcat 8.5. You just need to give the directory and then click on finish. You can see my server runtime environment name is 8.5. And this is the server name which will get displayed and the server host name is localhost. So that's completely fine. I'll click on next and it will ask me to add this particular. I'm not going to add it right now because I need to fix that particular H2 database error and then I'll move forward. So I'll just say finish. So that's how you can add the server. And if I want to show you where my Tomcat installation is, so I'll just show you that also. It's inside C drive. You can see Apache Tomcat and then I have this bin. So my directory structure is like this, C, and this is my Tomcat home directory where I have kept it. So I have the project, I have the server, but the only problem is if I try to add that particular thing and then execute it, it is not going to execute because, as I told you, my second problem is to fix this particular issue. That's the whole purpose of creating this particular video. So I have noted down these steps. So I'll share this particular document in the description of this particular video. So you can download it and then you can also work through this one. So it says in the first step, you need to extract the content of this H2 database and go inside the bin location. At the time of this particular recording, the H2 database version is 1.4.200. So you just need to take care of which H2 database version that you have been using. So you need to go inside that particular directory. And then you need to open a terminal window. So I have already downloaded and extracted in my Softfetch directory. So you can see I have downloaded H2 latest version and then I have this H2. I'll go inside this H2. I'll go inside bin. And this is a shortcut. What you can do, you can just type cmd here and it will open up a command prompt window for you. So you can see my command prompt window is directly inside this project software H2 and bin. So this is the first step that you need to do. Now you need to execute the below command to get the cell access to H2. So you can take this command and you can see the version is 1.4.200 because at the time of this recording, as I said earlier, this is the version which is available. So in the class path, you need to say this is the jar file. It has the main and then I need to log into the shell. So we'll take this command and then paste it here. Now it is asking the URL that you want to have for the database that you're going to create. As you can see here, so we are going to provide the details. So I'm going to show you what are the details that you need to provide. So you can just type here JDBC colon H2 colon the directory path. So usually if you see this particular tilde, it is going to be always be the user directory. And then inside this user directory, I'm telling H2 to create a database with the name of online shopping. The driver, so we don't have to specify any other driver. You can just press enter if you want to use the same value. User, so I'll keep it as SA. Password, I don't want to give any password. I've kept it blank. It's up to you if you want to keep any password and then you can just change in your configuration file as well. And then press enter. And now you have logged in inside the SQL. I don't want to add any SQL query here. So I'll just do an exit. So what we did just now is, so let me show you. If I go back to again to my user directory by pressing dot here in my run command, there is a file that is created called as this online shopping mv.db. So this is the file which your H2 database look for when it gives this particular error that it is not found or either pre-created. So what we did, we just pre-created it with our credentials here. Now, if you try to connect, And if you click on connect, first the error goes away. You need to select that it is generic H2 server. First of all, you need to do that thing. And then here, you need to give the name of your database that you created. So this is the same name that we have used, online shopping. And the username is SA. The password is blank, as I said. And then we are going to click on connect. As you can see, now we are able to connect to that particular database. So that's what been given here. So we just created that one and then we selected H2 server. The driver remains the same. You need to use this particular URL to get connected and get this particular console access. Okay, password was blank. Now we need to get the SQL query. So in your project, if you go back to your STS, if you open this shopping backend, now you need to select this H2 database queries.sql. So if you open this one, and you just need to copy the entire SQL query, you can just take it and then paste it here and then click on run. So it will create all the necessary tables here for you without any error. So you can run it as many times as you want. If you click on run once again, it will drop all your objects and then it will again recreate your table. So it's kind of an, you know, idempotent thing that we have done here. So you run it as many times, it is not going to affect this one and your tables are going to get created. So I'll do a clear, and just to show you the data that was created, I'll just do a run and you can see the data is being added here. So now the H2 database is working completely fine. So I'll go back here. You don't have to do any changes to this particular project. All you need to do is, I'll just close this database query and I'll just do a right click. I will click on this add and remove. And then we'll say online shopping I need to add, and then I'll click on finish. So as you can see, I've got this online shopping available here, and then I'll click on this run. I can open up the console for you all. You can see the console gets open up here. Okay, so the server has started up. So what I will do, I'll go back to this and then I will type http://localhost/8080 and then /online-shopping. You can see it will get mapped all my request mapping here. It will fetch the category, the product details, and then I have my project running here. Just to test that everything is working fine, so I'll do a login here. So for getting the admin login, you can type vk@gmail.com and the password is admin. You can do a login, and now you can see we have this manage product option available here. So I'll just click on this manage product, and you can already see we already have this 5 products available here. I will try to add one more product here. So let me do a test for XYZ brand. And this is a test product. Then we'll add the unit price. That's a 125. I have 4 quantity available. I will choose a file for the image. So I'll go to my downloads directory. And inside download directory, I have this. I'll just do an open. And let's put it in the television category. And then we'll click on save. It gives me product submitted successfully, and if I scroll down below, you can see the image is uploaded and the product is also added. So that's successfully running of your project in a Windows machine along with the error that we used to get for H2 database engine. So you need to just take care that which version you are using. So, and also in your pom.xml file, if you see in the shopping backend, and if I search for H2, you can see I'm using the exact same version of the database which is available here to connect easily with that particular project. So that's it for this particular video. In my next video, based on the request that I've received, that I need to set it up for MySQL server as well. So I'll show you how you can set up a MySQL server, the community version, and also you can directly use with this particular project without any fuss. So that's coming up in the next video. Thanks for watching this video.